Good evening, you're watching News Night and the Times Now news break on the D Company politician nexus has exploded. This channel has accessed explosive documents which prove that former Union Minister and NCP top gun Praful Patel signed a property deal with Iqbal Mirchi, a close associate of India's most wanted criminal Dawood Ibrahim, the face of the 93 Bombay blast. In fact, the deal with D Company was brokered between 2004 and 2007 when UPA was in power. Now, the big question is, and it's been asked a couple of times today, who buried this link, why, and how was Praful Patel allowed to become a union minister despite having dealings with the dreaded D Company? We confronted Praful Patel multiple times today. He had nothing to say. Here's one of those sequences where Times Now is putting a blunt question to Mr. Patel, who refuses to answer. Take a look.
What do you have to say about the land dealings with Mr. Iqbal Mirchi, the close aide of Dawood Ibrahim?
Yes, thank you.
Mr. Patel, the land dealings with...
Thank you.
Mr. Patel, what do you have to say about
you.
It?
Thank you.
Your name also reflects in Millennium developers.
Whatever.
As a promoter, and there is an agreement with Iqbal Mirchi also, a close aide of Mr. Dawood Ibrahim. Mr. Patel, what do you have to say? Mr. Patel, one reaction, please. How come Hazira Memon, the wife of Iqbal Mirchi, she stayed in... Mr. Patel? The wife of... Iqbal Mirchi is staying in Sija House. What do you have to say about it? Mr. Patel, one reaction, please. Mr. Patel?
Yeah?
Mr. Patel, you have travelled all the way from Mumbai for this one reaction, please. Mr. Patel, serious allegations against you. Allegations of money laundering as well.
And joining us tonight on News Night is Neeti Jain of the BJP. Dushyant Nagar is a political analyst, as is MC Abbas. Before I come to my guests, however, we also have some reactions lined up on the developments of the day and this explosive news break by Times Now. Here are some reactions first. Take a look. And we'll show you those reactions in just a bit here. In the meantime, let me just dive right into it. Neeti Jain, does this prove beyond doubt that there is something to be hidden and it's being hidden by Mr. Patel by not answering our questions? Those are simple questions, not misleading ones or even leading ones. He said thank you and turned away. If this link has been now completely exposed, should Mr. Patel do at the very least tell the people of this country whether or not there was some knowledge of who he was dealing with between 2004 and 2007 when the UPA was in power, when he was actually a minister in the UPA government? Neeti Jain, we'll start with you.
You know, we are so used to scams after scams coming out of the entire UPA government. But this takes it to completely another level. This is a terror funding case. And definitely, Praful ji needs to come out and answer to the people. I've seen your reporter has been running around this person since the morning from Bombay to Verol just to get one reaction out of it.
What a wild, baseless allegation is that?
Sir, those are the allegations that are coming out. If you're not aware of that,
what proof do you have?
If you're not aware of that, those are the allegations that are coming out. There is no way that you can come out and save this today.
Terror funding scam.
The man needs to come out and answer the people of this country. The person needs to come out and answer.
Mr. Abbas, I don't remember asking you a question, sir. Mr. Abbas, I do not remember asking you a question on this debate till now. So I did ask Neeti. You let her finish and then I'll come to you. Go ahead, Neeti.
All right.
So Congress comes out and distances itself from whatever is happening. NCP comes out and says this is election time, so this is political vendetta. But nobody is coming out and saying what is happening. Just come out and say ki sab galat hai, sab jhoot hai. Praful Patel ne kuch nahi kiya hai. Utna to bolo. But nobody is coming out and saying any of those questions. These are public figures. They need to come out and answer these very serious allegations that are being leveled against him.
All right. Now, Mr. Abbas, now coming to you. First of all, let me just clarify that Mr. Patel's representatives have denied all allegations as baseless. Having said that, what we have in black and white today, and what Times Now has been running the entire day, that news break, we in fact broke that at 1:40 p.m. in the afternoon before anybody else. It shows clearly that Mr. Patel, who was then a minister, signed on those documents. This is a deal that was brokered for 3 years, 2004-2007. That was the time frame. He was the minister. And to make matters worse for Mr. Patel, these allegations from the ED, they suspect not only a money laundering angle, but also a suspected hawala link. Now, these are not frivolous charges. The ED, of course, is a responsible agencies. If they want to suspect a hawala link or a money laundering link, they'll think twice before they just put it out there. So if they are investigating those angles, shouldn't Mr. Patel then come out and say that, look, the ED is biased, at least speak to the media and say, look, I've done nothing wrong. If he has nothing to fear, then he has nothing to fear. Why avoid the media? Why be evasive?
All right. Adnan Saab, firstly, any channel, any news channel does not comprise of asking authority what an enforcement directorate does. An enforcement directorate has summoned him. And yes, I do agree with you. Praful Patel Sahab is certainly answerable and he must completely cooperate with the enforcement directorate on all the charges which have been leveled against him or mentioned in the ED dossier. Also coming to the point now is the Maharashtra General Assembly elections. Therefore, leaders such as Sharad Pawar, Praful Patel are being geared by
Abbas, the paper is out. His signature is on the paper. Yes. The deal was signed. Whether it came out four months ago or four months later, how does it matter? Does it take away from the gravity of the link that the ED suspects? That the deal was brokered between a sitting minister, sir, in the UPA era and a criminal known to be an associate of Dawood Ibrahim.
Sir, essentially the thing is that you have
Chota Rajan given a ticket. He's contesting. His brother Nipak Nikalje. He's contesting from Republican Party of India.
He's not.
BJP ally.
Mr. Abbas, you are misinformed. He was given a ticket. That ticket was rescinded, sir. He was dropped. He was dropped by the RPI. But that's not even the point here. I'm trying to. That's not even the point here. The point is there is evidence.
Why in the first place give him a ticket?
There is evidence, sir.
Why in the first place?
There is evidence that
sir, you have Chota allegations Rajan, against you, and
ticket,
you have no answer. You are talking about a ticket that has been withdrawn.
Direct link
that has
of
been
BJP
withdrawn.
And it's alive.
And even today,
in the
I tell you, even today, I will tell you
this
that if there are such allegations on any of the representatives of the BJP, I assure you that the
all right,
BJP
Mr. Abbas, give me a second. I don't want to. All right.
Give a ticket to
Niti and Abbas, let's take a breath here. Let me go back to Dushyant Nagar, who hasn't spoken.
Sir,
he's been waiting patiently. Neeti, give me a second. On the record, last report I heard, Neeti Jain is right. That ticket was rescinded. He is no longer the RPI candidate there. But that's a different story. Main aapse puchna chahunga, Dushyant
ji. Give him the ticket first place.
No, listen, rescinded after that.
Party or it's alive.
Rescinded after that. The moment, no, rescinded after that. Not the point.
You have a link.
Not the point.
You don't get into whataboutery. You please answer about Praful Patel. You answer about the corruption.
Okay, please.
All
right, Neeti, one second.
One second.
Dushyant ji, ye deal jo hai, jo paper Times Now ke paas hai, uspe signature hai Praful Patel ji ka. वो मंत्री थे 2004-2007 के बीच में यूपीए की सरकार थी वो एविएशन मिनिस्टर भी थे अब उस टाइम पे जो ये सिग्नेचर हुए हैं आज बाहर आए हैं वगैरह वगैरह अगर ये एलिगेशन गलत भी है जैसे कि प्रफुल्ल पटेल जी कहते हैं अकॉर्डिंग टू हिम दीज आर बेसलेस एलिगेशन बट अगर ये पेपर सामने आया है तो कम से कम उनको ये नहीं कहना चाहिए कि बाहर आके जनता से कहें मीडिया से कहें या एक क्लैरिफिकेशन ही दे दें कि अगर ईडी ने एलिगेशन लगाई है तो गलत है या ईडी के पास कोई एजेंडा है वगैरह वगैरह मुंह मोड़ के अपनी गाड़ी में बैठ के चले जाने से तो सस्पेशन और ही बढ़ेगा दुष्यंत जी
निश्चित रूप से लेकिन देखिए उन्होंने कहा है कि वो उचित समय पर जवाब देंगे अब बात भाजपा
इससे उचित समय क्या होता है दुष्यंत जी इतने सीरियस आरोप लगा रहे हैं
उनके ऊपर आरोप लगे वो अपना कागज देखेंगे डॉक्यूमेंट्स देखेंगे ये लीगल मैटर है तो अपना वकील से हो सकता है सलाह ले। नहीं मैडम, आप बता दीजिए, पीएमसी बैंक के बोर्ड में आपकी पार्टी से जुड़े लोग हैं, आप उनके ऊपर बता दीजिए। अभी कुछ दिन पहले येदुरप्पा साहब की डायरी के पेज वायरल हो रहे थे,
बहुत सीरियस चार्जेस हैं।
आप बता दीजिए, आपके बहुत सारे उनकी डायरी के
बहुत सारे पेज वायरल हो रहे थे।
येदुरप्पा जी को आपने मुख्यमंत्री बना दिया मैडम।
सर ये देश की सुरक्षा का सवाल है, आप इस वक्त
पीएमसी बैंक
इतना हल्के में इधर उधर की बातें करके मत डालिए। जानती हूँ आपके पास कोई जवाब नहीं है,
आरोप लग रहा है लेकिन
जानती हूँ आपके पास कोई जवाब नहीं है, आप इधर उधर की बातें ही करेंगे।
द्वारा सरकार के ऊपर कर्जा क्यों बढ़ गया?
देखिए वो सब
जानना चाहता है, आप बताओ।
नहीं दुष्यंत जी, ठीक है, आपके सवाल भी लोग कहेंगे वैलिड हैं, लेकिन लेकिन
हमने क्या काम किया उस मुद्दे पे डिबेट होगी तो मैं बताऊं।
लेकिन सुनिए दुष्यंत जी, अभी आज इस मुद्दे पे बात कर लेते हैं, पीएमसी पे कल बात कर लेंगे। एक सेकंड, सिंपल सा सवाल है, डाइग्रेस नहीं करते हैं, वो भी करेंगे, पीएमसी बहुत बड़ा इशू है, उस पर भी डिबेट करेंगे। अभी हम सिर्फ इतना जानना चाहते हैं कि जो एलिगेशंस कल हमको पता चली थी, टाइम नाउ की एक्सक्लूसिव स्टोरी थी, आज फॉलो अप हमने उस पर किया है, सिग्नेचर्स हैं, ब्लैक एंड व्हाइट में हैं, प्रफुल्ल पटेल जी को हमने पॉइंट ब्लैंक सवाल पूछा है, उन्होंने सिर्फ इतना कहा है थैंक यू मैं उचित समय पे कहूंगा। लेकिन गिवन द ग्रेविटी ऑफ द चार्जेस, जो सिवेरिटी ऑफ द चार्जेस, अब ईडी जब कहती है डॉसिये में कि वो हवाला लिंक भी सस्पेक्ट करते हैं, प्रोब कर रहे हैं, और ईडी ये भी कहती है कि मनी लॉन्ड्रिंग एंगल भी प्रोब किया जा रहा है, ये किसी अरे गहरे क्रिमिनल के साथ नहीं हो रहा है। दैट्स व्हाई आई कीप कमिंग बैक टू दिस पॉइंट रोशन जी, दिस इज विद अ नोन एसोसिएट ऑफ दाऊद इब्राहिम, इकबाल मिर्ची, हु वाज रनिंग फ्रॉम द इंडियन अथॉरिटीज, वाज पार्ट ऑफ द कंस्पिरेसी ऑफ द बॉम्बे ब्लास्ट केस ऑफ 1993। दीज आर नॉट जस्ट पेटी क्रिमिनल्स, दीज आर नेफेरियस क्रिमिनल्स हु हैव एन एंटायर नेटवर्क अराउंड द वर्ल्ड, और इंडिया के मोस्ट वांटेड लोग हैं ये।
मैं सर समझ गया, अगर ईडी के पास में पूरे एविडेंस हैं तो इंतजार किस बात का हो रहा है भाई, आप उनको अरेस्ट करके जेल में क्यों नहीं डाल देते? लेकिन सच्चाई यह है कि कुछ एविडेंस है ही नहीं, सरकार सिर्फ प्रफुल्ल पटेल को
ऑर्डर्स लेने की जरूरत,
ऑपोजिशन के नेताओं को चुनाव में फायदा लेने के लिए सिर्फ और सिर्फ दुष्प्रचार कर रही है, उससे ज्यादा कुछ नहीं है। अगर उन्होंने कुछ गलत काम किया है तो क्यों वेट कर रहे हो भाई डिबेट का?
आपने सवाल उठाया, नीति जय विल रिस्पॉन्ड टू दिस, इफ द ईडी सस्पेक्ट सच अ स्ट्रॉन्ग लिंक, व्हाई हैवन्ट दे देन मूव्ड ऑन मिस्टर पटेल? बिकॉज नीति दिस इज ऑल्सो ट्रू दैट दिस इज नॉट कम अप नाउ और अ वीक अगो, द ईडी सेज एंड सोर्सेज विद इन द ईडी हैव टोल्ड माय कॉलीग्स हियर एंड टाइम्स नाउ दैट दिस इन्वेस्टिगेशन हैज बीन गोइंग ऑन नॉट फॉर वीक्स बट फॉर द पास्ट 4 to 5 months।
Right, so I just need to make 3 very quick points. One, the investigation has been going on for very long, but the 2 people that have been arrested through which this link has come out has happened very recently, a few days back. The ED is doing its job and it does not need any instructions from Mr. Dushyant Nagar. That said, when you come down to elections and you talk about elections, sir, jab hum bolte hain ki one election kara lo taki har cheez ko aap chunav se jod kar na dekho, aap us par bhi aapko problem hai ki nahi hum one elections bhi nahi karwayenge. तीसरी चीज, बीजेपी इज वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग, बीजेपी शिवसेना अलायंस इज वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग इन महाराष्ट्र, वी डोंट हैव टू गेट इनटू दीज टैक्टिक्स। एज अ सिटीजन ऑफ दिस कंट्री आई वुड रियली रियली होप दैट दीज लिंक्स एंड दीज एलिगेशंस आर नॉट करेक्ट, बिकॉज अदरवाइज दैट वुड मीन दैट फॉर 70 ईयर्स वी वर बींग रूल्ड बाय पीपल who were indulging in all of these things. We have suffered at the hands of the people who were supposed to save us.
Okay, Abbas, once you come in, please go ahead.
Stupid election, Abbas, you want to respond to this?
The 70 years ruled by people charge, go ahead. MC Abbas, please, nobody else.
Tum ji case se laga ke aaj tak.
Nahi, Dushyant ji, MC Abbas ko aana dijiye, please.
Okay, so the BJP, okay. Dushyant Nagar sahab, main baat kar raha hun, ji, shukriya. May I come in, please? Athar sahab.
May I
come in? Thank you.
Okay. Please let MC Abbas respond. Niti ji, no, you have to listen now. You've spoken, you have to listen to the other side. Go ahead, MC Abbas.
Yes. Firstly, Firstly, the BJP spokesperson have got the facts absolutely wrong. It is not just a few days back that this link was found. No, absolutely not, madam. This has been going on for a while, and they have it in present in the dossier, or the court order as well, the court receiver
sir,
as well,
was,
and all
when
of this.
Mohammed Yusuf so do not distract the viewers
by giving these
When was Mohammed Yusuf and Harun Yusuf arrested? Please don't correct me on my facts.
You correct yourself on your facts. Second point.
So tell me, give me the dates, sir. He was arrested about two weeks back.
Liable.
They are arrested two weeks back, and that is where this link is coming out to the ED,
and he shall go ahead and cooperate with them. No. BJP spokesperson, you don't have to suppress
my
voice.
So we are very thankful.
I give you
that.
All the time. Please allow
me
to speak.
We are very thankful for that. But you please
correct,
tell me, Congress
your,
comes out.
If your facts correct,
sir,
don't
Congress
give,
comes
don't
out
peddle lies on the
this
show.
Very last
do not peddle
sir,
lies
Congress
on the show.
Out and says
get your
that we
facts
are distancing
checked.
Ourselves from
do
this
not peddle lies
show.
On the show. Don't peddle lies
sir,
on the
my
show.
Facts
you need
are
to
right.
get your facts
you,
corrected,
you
madam. I don't know why the level of
BJP
spokesperson has dropped. The
sir,
level of BJP spokespersons has dropped.
No, please don't make any personal comments, Mr. Abbas. Let's not make personal jibes with each other. I'm interested in facts, not in personal commentary, please.
Why do you speak when we are speaking?
No, please, Mr. Abbas, Niti Jain. No, you need to calm down. Both of you need to calm down. I'm sorry. MC Abbas, Niti Jain, both of you need to calm down. Abbas, listen to me. No personal comments on this show. I'm not interested in personal commentary and jibes. Speak on the facts if you have to. If you want to go through your arguments, nobody will interrupt you. Niti Jain, just give him time
certainly,
to give his argument. No
sir,
personal comments, though, please. No personal
facts,
comments against Niti Jain or anybody else.
But why is the BJP spokesperson not allowing me to speak?
Now, come back to
not
the point.
Not allowing me to present
come
my
back
points.
To the facts, please. Let's move on. Let's move on. Go ahead, Abbas.
Yes, so Praful Patel is certainly liable, and he shall cooperate with summon. The summon from the ED has come in, and he shall cooperate and is truly answerable to everything. But from what we know, since so many days we've been debating about this, the Patel family bought this CJ House property from the Maharaj of Gwalior in 1963. 1978 to 2005, 27 years, it was under litigation, and the order is in the court. The court receiver says that none of the names mentioned of the D-gang members are there in the news report are not a part of this. So that is categorically stated from the court that none of the names mentioned are indeed in the court's order. So the other thing which is coming from the ED, yes, Mr. Praful Patel is wholly, solely responsible to the enforcement directorate, and he shall answer to them accordingly.
Okay. Niti Jain, what do you think of this argument that the lawyers and representatives of Mr. Patel have been saying? And I'll come back to Dushyant Nagar also on this. But first, Niti Jain, the fact that the court ordered, the High Court ordered the quote-unquote illegal occupant of the house, which turns out was perhaps somehow connected to the Mirchi family there. And the Patel's argument seemed to be that there was nothing they could have done about it since it was a court ordered rehabilitation or redevelopment of that particular area to the quote-unquote illegal occupant. Now, does that automatically mean that Millennium Developers, which is in fact Mr. Patel's company, he's the shareholder there as well, even though he doesn't speak on that particular angle, couldn't have given a choice really on who to rehabilitate since it was a court order? This is a very technical legal point that representatives Niti of Mr. Patel have been pushing since yesterday. What do you think of it?
You know, I would not comment on what the court has said because that's not my jurisdiction to be doing so. That said, this is not the only point. There were a lot of these Benami transactions that have also happened. The money has been sent to UAE from which the Iqbal Mirchi, he's purchased a hotel there and all of those things. It's not just one small case. If it is the court, the ED is smart enough to not act on it. And that is just simple common sense that we are talking about. Secondly, what he is talking about is ki isse liya tha land, usse liya tha. Sir, ye do din purani baat hai. There is an agreement that is being signed. There is a signed agreement. So all of those things are there, and let him go and answer. Na? Let him answer to the people of this country, to the agencies of this country.
He is saying he will cooperate about it.
Why do you want to hide this entire thing and create
what is
an issue?
Fair enough. Hold on. Before I go to Dushyant Nagar, I want our viewers just to get a sense of what other politicians and big political names are saying on this controversy after the Times Now news break on what the ED suspects could be a hawala link, perhaps even a money laundering link. Here's some reactions coming in throughout the course of the day. After that, we'll take closing comments from all my guests. Take a look at this first.
We have got a document which says that Praful Patel has signed on documents along with Iqbal Mirchi's wife.
I don't know suddenly how the documents come during the election period. ED is a part of BJP or BJP is a part of ED?
But the ED says that they are investigating for a long while.
ED says, nah. ED also accused Sharad Pawar of it. ED accused every opposition leader of it. ED is doing what BJP cannot do. When BJP is into doldrums, so they have all their agencies functioning.
But sir, these are allegations of documents with someone who's accused of crimes as heinous as 93 blasts.
Allegations. It's allegations. They did not raise in this issue before elections.
But people may say that was because you were in power. That's why the allegations didn't come earlier.
I'm asking now, before the declaration of the election dates. Is it in recent times that Iqbal Mirchi was caught?
So NCP is going to say it is political vendetta.
It is absolutely political vendetta, absolutely. Yes. Absolutely. I challenge the ED to come into the press and say it in open. Why does they throw a paper into some Godi media and then raise it?
Sir, that is unfair of you to say. But the investigating agency is coming up with this. We are reporting only whatever the investigating agency
to come to Bombay and take a press conference.
In power now, if any deal was made, any agreement was made, this government, Modi government, should investigate and tell us what has happened.
But wouldn't the government of the day have had any inkling about such?
No, I'll get information about it. I'm not aware of this thing. But let us not forget that today there is a government in Delhi, I hope. And I think if there is anything wrong has happened, they should investigate and tell us what has happened.
आज देश की जनता जानना चाहती है, शरद पवार जी से जानना चाहती है, प्रफुल्ल पटेल जी से और एनसीपी से जानना चाहती है, आखिर दाऊद इब्राहिम और डी कंपनी के साथ एनसीपी के क्या संबंध है? दी सिग्नेचर्स आर इक्वल टू द स्मोकिंग गन, मतलब इन सिग्नेचर के माध्यम से ये वह साक्ष्य है जिनके माध्यम से हम कह सकते हैं कि कोई ना कोई लिंक तो है. वॉज इट जस्ट अ प्रॉपर्टी डील? Was it just a property deal or there were deals beyond property is the question. The national security of India was jeopardized and compromised by none other than the then government, that is the UPA government.
So, दो क्लियर नैरेटिव्स आ रहे हैं दुष्यंत जी. बीजेपी कहती है कि अब नेशनल सिक्योरिटी का सवाल बन चुका है, ये बहुत ही ग्रेव एलिगेशंस है, पटेल साहब को क्लैरिफाई करना चाहिए. मिस्टर पटेल कहते हैं कि हाँ, हम उचित समय पर बात करेंगे और ये सब इलेक्शन से पहले ही क्यों नहीं होता, क्यों होता है? पवार साहब को भी ईडी ने कहा था कुछ, लेकिन वो ईडी हैड बैक ऑफ, उन्होंने कहा था कि आप बाद में इन्वेस्टिगेशन ज्वाइन करिए, जबकि पवार साहब ने कहा था कि हम खुद ही ज्वाइन करना चाहते हैं. नाउ बिफोर आई प्ले दैट वन मोर सीक्वेंस, मिस्टर पटेल, प्रफुल्ल पटेल,
ये जो आपने सवाल उठाया है, बहुत बड़ा सवाल है कि ईडी ने कहा शरद पवार जी से कि आप आराम से ज्वाइन करिए, क्योंकि उनके समर्थक लोग जुट गए थे मुंबई के अंदर. तो बताइए, ये ईडी एजेंसी है, जांच के लिए वो आना चाहते हैं, उन्होंने मना कर दिया. भाई क्या बात है, पिछले 2005 से आज तक 14 साल में 2400 केस ईडी ने रजिस्टर्ड किए. उनका कॉन्विक्शन रेशो भी हमें देखना होगा, कितने लोग कॉन्विक्ट हुए, कितने लोग दोषी पाए गए. तो किसी संस्था को, किसी एजेंसी को देश के प्रति जवाबदेह होना चाहिए,
खत्म हो जाएगी,
देश के प्रति जवाबदेह होना चाहिए, ना कि किसी राजनीतिक दल
की देश को जवाब दे दो. बेचारा रिपोर्टर सुबह से पूछ रहा है, जवाब दे नहीं रहे.
ओके वन मोर, इनफैक्ट आई वांट टू प्ले वन मोर सीक्वेंस विद मिस्टर पटेल. जस्ट गिव मी अ सेकंड दुष्यंत जी, आप ये भी देख लीजिए. दिस इज वन मोर टाइम व्हेन टाइम्स नाउ ट्राई टू कन्फ्रंट मिस्टर प्रफुल्ल पटेल. हियर इज व्हाट हैपेंड, टेक अ लुक.
One reaction, please, sir. Mr. Patel, we have come from Mumbai. One reaction. Is this your signature? Can you confirm your signature, please? One signature. Is this your signature signed when you were a Union Minister in 2007? With Iqbal Mirchi's family, a close aide of, former close aide of Dawood Ibrahim. We have proof.
चला था, चला था, आशा आशा.
धान उत्पादक करणाऱ्या शेतकऱ्यांना 3000 रुपये हमी भाव.
Yet another instance where Mr. Patel refused to speak to Times Now and has said I'd speak at the right moment. Unfortunately, we're out of time on this one, but expect this story perhaps to have more twists and turns before we have some closure on what exactly happened. Thank you, Neeti Jain, for joining us. Thank you, MC Abbas and Dushyant Nagar. That was Newsnight. I'm Asar Khan. Thank you for watching.